Good morning, cyber traders. Happy Friday on this 24th of August. Hopefully everyone's enjoying this summer. Looks like a lot of people already started taking a little off. Nah, not really, not that many. I figure attendance would be a hell of a lot lower, but my God, everyone's like, well, what else are we gonna do, right? Good to see you too, Gene. Mark, good to see you. Craig, Ken, good to see you. Steve, Neil, good to see you. Wendy, Grant. Hey Grant, you know what? I'm not kidding around, but I really hope that gold does go back to 1600. I do own it at 16. You know what's pretty funny? A lot of people don't realize it. You know, you watch these commercials on TV, and everyone's keep preaching about like buy silver, Roslyn gold. You see these commercials, and it's like I can't tell you how many times I'm watching it, and then and buy gold, you're safe, this and that. And do you realize the spread that's on gold? People don't realize that, like, you know, when you're talking about gold's up $3, $5, $10, $20, do you know what the spread is if you got a good deal with spot? Anyone have any idea? I mean, everyone keeps talking about it's that's right. I don't know, Mike. I think it's a little bit more than that. They never tell you that, but depending who's going to sell to you. But I think it's almost like $40. You're saying 20? I think it was like 40 almost. So that for you to break, you see, that's the beauty about what you understand about the stock market is that when you trade, and the big thing we teach you in phase one is that before you ever get into a position, you're already losing. So if you bought gold, right, you got to remember you're not buying it at spot, you know, whatever it's at 1200, whatever it is, you're buying at like 1240, and it's got to go 1240 just for you to break even. So always remember that. Wow, better to buy the miners, Grant says. Well, once again, you know, some people like to just it's a tangible item, you know what I mean? Like silver, like I own a ton of silver. I made a killing. I always tell you the story about I used to play on Christmas time giving out silver coins to all my family, all the little kids, and I bought silver not knowing I paid $13 and I went to 50, you know, if you guys remember that one. And they paid him $50 the year after, and the kids were like, I was teaching them. It's a great little lesson. You always want to teach, you know, your kids good lessons about making money, especially their beautiful coins, but they're cheap. Anyway, spread on that was like also like $1, $2, whatever it is. Anyway, so that's my gold story. But let's get right into it, guys. Today is Friday. It is absolutely beautiful, not a cloud in the sky. Let's hope everyone. I know we had a couple of students here from Hawaii. Hopefully, you guys are batching. You know, hopefully, you guys are gonna be safe out there. You know, I know a hurricane's coming there, but you know, listen, some of us don't feel like we're on the internet. It's like we all work together like a team, and you don't realize that. Sometimes the weather affects us all over. But the reason why I always bring up New York is because this is the financial capital of the world. A lot of traders are here. You know, and what happens with that, a lot of people are going away. And it's going to be like this going into this week and going into next week, too. I think it's going to be really, really slow next week, especially going into Labor Day. So just be prepared. You know, but there are companies coming out with good news. I mean, you heard what's going on with a lot of like Walmart and Target and all of them. They're killing it. People are going back to the stores. You know, everybody thought that retail was dead, brick and mortar was dead. They're killing it. They're killing it. Rates are doing great. By the way, I'm really looking forward to see the earnings announcements on BJ's. BJ's, you know, is on the 28th. And let me tell you, because that's an IPO and you know we own that. But guys, how did BJ's do yesterday? Oh my God, we killed it yesterday with that big spike out there. Fausto flag, everything broke all-time highs, you know. So anyway, a lot of good stuff going on, and so we're gonna check that out. But anyway, let's get right into it. That was one of our big winners. Let's get right into what's gonna happen here Friday morning. We all know how to trade a Friday morning. Remember, when it comes to Fridays, you know, you're going into a weekend. You know, I told you I'm gonna be away. I gotta drop off my firstborn at college and kind of freaking out. My wife too. It's gonna be tough on us, you know, to lose a child, you know, going to school, but we're very proud of it. And but that's what it is what it is. I told you guys that story yesterday. But anyway. By that happening, it's you know it's not always the busiest days on a Friday. We always get a good action on Friday afternoons. But you know what? There's a couple of things that are moving this morning, and we're going to check them out. First of all, the AMD trade. That one has been popping. You know, and remember that we learned in class to be a good swing trader and a good option trader, you gotta know how to day trade. And this stock has been treating us very well on a swing trade. AMD, look at that. It finally broke out. Stock has been staled here for a long, long time, and now it's finally making a big move. So, and the only reason why we know that is because we've been watching it over the course of the day. So, that's how you figure, do I want to swing trade the stock? We don't like to swing trade because the problem is still about money management. You type your buying power, you're like, and when we day trade, it's like, listen, you always got to be free in cash. Remember, one of the biggest slogans I used to go by, I want all of you guys to know, is cash is king. Okay. People, always, are you liquid or are you not liquid? What are you liquid for? And it's like, I got my money tied up and I'm like, forget it. I'm going to the next guy's got cash. Cash is king. And the problem is when you swing trade, you're not liquid. And then that hurts you. But there are times when you have to, you say, you know what? I got a little money here. Let me put it here. Let me put it there on a swing trade, which actually we're coming up with our swing trading course is coming up in the next month or so. So we'll keep you up to date. But anyway, it's been a great day trade, but a phenomenal swing trade. And by the way, also with the BJ's trade, I'm doing great on that swing trade also. I don't have the AMD. I know some of you do. I'm actually in the BJ's. All right. Yeah, I know. I'm going to talk about that Benito, that other IPO. I got that on my list too. The TRLY, been doing phenomenal also. That was another big winner. We're going to check that out in a little bit. MDXG, another one that's been making on the watch list. Stock took a big hit from 16 all the way down to about the 3. It's been moving up nice, quietly. Great iceberg over orders there on the matrix. You got a lot of decent orders. It kind of like phased out in pre-market though. It had a nice little gap up, went to about 495 and now it's trouble about 465, which is okay. I'm going to keep an eye on it. So we've seen these things pop from nowhere. So that one's going to make the watch list. SSC, my God, that has been unbelievable. That's been treating us very, very well. We've been trading that stock at $2 a couple of days ago. We're into $4. Look, she's gapping up big time right now. That probably is one of my favorites. Look at those orders. Look at those big block orders on the offer. Look at those seller orders. Let's see if they get executed. Right now, they're holding the resistance levels right there. This is the resistance right there. You got the resistance right there. That's the resistant guy right there that's holding it. If he gets executed following that time in sales, bam, we learned a very valuable lesson how to utilize time and sales and big iceberg orders. And that's what we're looking for. The high frequency trades are what make these things come to fruition. See, next one, CRON is on the watch list. This one has been trending a lot nicer. Higher highs, nice little push at 919. It's going to probably test this resistance levels right around here. Once again, great iceberg orders, not up huge, 7%, 500,000 shares already traded. It's got great movement, great trend. That one's doing great. Ben brought up the TLRY. That also has been a great swing trade. That was an IPO that we've been trading, and once it broke out of that 26, look where it went. Went all the way to 40. It's breaking all-time highs. This stock is doing incredible. What does it do? Well, why is it up? Who in the hell cares? Remember, this looks exactly like the IQ trade that we traded on the IPO. TRLY doing phenomenal, okay? Just like Sono. We did well on Sono. Sono was a great IPO. A lot of IPOs, unbelievable how many are coming out. But remember, all of you fellow traders out here, to be a good stock trader, to trade IPOs, remember, you got to be a minimum of a level two cyber trader. So be careful on these positions. Couple of stocks, one, two other stocks I want to talk about. I think it's this one. Nope, spelt it wrong. What was it right here? I had one more stock I wanted to bring up. Why am I? Oh, that's it. The SUPV. Okay. SUPV, let's keep an eye on this one. The stock is getting pretty hit. It might get a little dead cat bounce. I want to keep an eye on that. You know what the big news is today? Here I'm talking about so much about brick and mortars. Gap is getting killed. By the way, who shops at Gap anymore? Anybody shop at Gap? I mean, I don't know too many people shop at Gap anyway. Is it GPS? I spelt it. Was that the one? Is that it? GPS, is that the symbol? I think that's it, right? Is that Gap? GPS, right? Yeah, that's Gap stores. All right, just absolutely. All right, so anyway, you're hearing all Gap's taking a little bit of a hit also right here. You know, listen, don't want to throw my two cents in it. It's not important. It's irrelevant. You know what I mean? But at the end of the day, we're here to make money. So if it does trend down, I mean, there's buyers coming in right now. But if it does trend down, it could be a nice short too. Looks like it's still got some room to break down right here. All right. Anything I'm missing that I'm not that I missed out? Charles said ETSY. Popped, but no volume. Yeah, no, good call right there. Yeah, well, it's got decent volume. 100,000 shares already traded. No real clear trend though there, Charles. But and also the spread's pretty big too, so let's be cautious on that one. All right, Wayne says the J Nut. We've done really well with these ETFs. Was it the JNUG? Oh, there we go. We've done really well, but they've been taking some big hits lately. These gold ETFs. But once again, I as of right now, I think we should keep focus on the ones that give us less risk, more reward. Right now, with these stocks, you know, these are second protocol. All right. Everyone, anything I missed I did not call out? I think we got a pretty decent list right here. AMD. We got the BJs, we got the MDXG. We got a lot of them here. You got a lot of good stocks that are moving. All right, anything I'm missing? All right, good. All right, so anyway, that's our watch list. Listen, if I don't see you guys here in the afternoon, you have a phenomenal weekend. I'll see you back here next week. Listen, take the money and run. If you do well, just go out there. Take your profit and go, because you can lose it just as quickly. That's what you're taught in class. This is what we preach every day. And remember, this is, you know, when we're in the cyber group room, when we're trading in the trading room right now, this is all about working together like a team. So there's not an educational class. Don't get asking questions. Why is this up? Why is this down? Talk to education advisor. Do your coaching. Get into the classroom, watch your videos, do it over the weekend, because when September comes rolls around, like I told you, and I repeat this 1,000 times over, September and October, November, you trade those 3 months. You could make enough money in those 3 months to pay off the whole year. You could probably take off the rest of the year off. But you got to learn now. Don't learn at the best times of the trade. Learn when on the quiet times, which is now. Guys, good luck today. Happy trading. And thank you very much, Nancy, for that. Looking forward to it. It's gonna be a little tough, but it's gonna be emotional. But we'll get through it. I always got you guys to fall back on, right? All right, everybody. Good luck today. Happy trading.